A case that's divided a community and pitted some citizens against the police department.
And tonight we have more details in the Silk Plant Forest case.
The victim, Jill Marker, was brutally beaten, and Calvin Michael Smith was convicted in that attack.
However, some of the evidence taken from the scene in 1995 had not been tested until recently. Well, now the results are back.
Greg Thomas is live in our newsroom with tonight's big story at 6 o'clock.
Guys, a police committee is working on a report to be finished at the end of the summer. That report will recommend either reopen the case or keep it closed. And they say the results of these new tests do not answer a lot of the lingering questions.
We were hopeful that definitive information would have been gained from these examinations, but that just is not the case.
Monday afternoon, Winston-Salem Police Chief Scott Cunningham spoke about the crime lab testing done on the clothes Jill Marker wore when she was attacked, as well as on a stained piece of cardboard from the crime scene. Here are the lab's results. All of the blood found belonged to Jill Marker. None of the hairs found on her clothes came from Calvin Michael Smith. The crime lab says the hairs came from someone with Caucasian characteristics, but they do not match up with anyone associated with the case.
This examination provides no new evidence. It does not definitively place anyone but Jill at the scene, nor does it definitively exclude anyone from the scene.
We asked why more DNA was not found at the crime scene. Cunningham answered that the way Marker was attacked does not lend itself to a lot of physical evidence.
In struggles, there's going to be that give and take, that close-up action, where there is going to be a lot more likelihood of gaining physical evidence from the attacker. In this case, the contact was with an unknown blunt object to Jill Marker.
The committee also has not figured out why the pieces of evidence were never sent to the crime lab during the original investigation.
For whatever reason, everyone involved decided it wasn't at that time to be sent off to the lab. Police department knew about it, DA's office knew about it, the defense attorneys knew about it.
We spoke to Calvin Michael Smith's attorney, David Pishko, this afternoon. He told us these results add to Smith's contention that he was not at the scene. Police point out a female officer who was African-American came to Marker's aid that night after she was attacked, but no hair or DNA from that officer was found on Marker's clothes during the tests. Police say that shows the test simply did not tell us what happened that night. Wanda?
All right, thanks, Craig. Jill Marker was pregnant at the time of the attack. She later delivered a baby while still in a coma. That attack left Marker blind and unable to speak. After a 14-month investigation, Winston-Salem police arrested and charged Calvin Smith. Jury convicted him in December 1997 and sentenced him to 23 years behind bars. Smith has appealed his conviction several times. His most recent appeal was denied by the state. This is a story, of course, we will continue to follow. You want to stay with WXII and WXII12.com as we bring you the latest updates on the Silk Plant Forest case.